I don't have a name. I used to have one, and a lot of people would like to know what it is. Go ahead. Some call me Tribbly, and as a name it suffices. I've been called many things. A burglar, a hoodlum, a criminal. Ooh. I prefer to think of myself as a gentlemanly thief. And tonight I have something potentially very rewarding in store. I didn't say the words in the wrong order that time. My fence phones me in the middle of the night and asks if I know about Defoe Manor. Apparently, the last of the Defoe line has obligingly died without heirs, leaving all the family valuables up for grabs. The lawyers have got the place locked up tight, of course, but that's never stopped me before.
Lovely, yes.
Okay. And the place is, of course, deserted.
Well, yes. And there's the door, and there's the shadowy figure.
Yes, this should be a painless and rewarding evening's entertainment. Let's just knock on some wood real quick. That's... Too bad you don't got any wood in your car, Mr. Trilby.
That's not wood either, but whatever.
What do you mean it's not wood?
It's particle board.
Which is made of?
Well, okay, play the game.
Okay, here's Five Days a Stranger. I'm the Poltergeist 5000, this is my mom.
Hi! Isn't this going to be fun? You're going to play a game while your mom watches.
Well, we do this all the time before. I've shown you Ace Attorney.
Yeah, okay.
And what was the other one? And Mother 3, don't forget that.
That was good, yeah. Okay.
Anyway, right. Let's go. Day 1.
So who's this? Oh, he doesn't have a name.
His name is Trilby.
He has a name.
What's his, like, title? His
stuck
nickname.
On the carpet.
That's a grappling hook.
That's no... Okay. Sure, go with that.
And the gentleman thief makes his entrance. Okay, so here
what
we go.
What is his face? Okay.
Oh, he's wearing, like, a mask, so you can't see.
Oh.
Let's use the safe. Damn. Empty. Guess the family solicitor got here first.
Maybe there's another safe.
Painting.
I betcha.
It's too bulky to carry on. It's also unsigned and therefore valueless.
Yeah, but look behind it. Okay, never mind.
Certificates. They have no value to anyone except the owner, and he's dead. That was just the sound of, like, the manor creaking. Okay. Because, you know, we're on, like, the ocean or something. Mm. The drawers are all empty or full of meaningless paperwork. A chair. It might be worth a big enough pocket change, but I thought I could get it down into my car. Cabinet. I can see from here that it's empty, even though I walked towards it. Books. I have no interest in these books. Well, it doesn't matter if you have interest in them. Can't you appraise some books, dude?
Well, what is... So, we don't know... Is he just looking for, like, obviously?
I prefer to leave the same way I came in. You're gonna explore one room...
What?
...and then leave.
He can't open the... What's at the window?
Those are the
lines.
Oh,
okay.
Window.
It's just the...
It won't open. It must have been jarred shut somehow. Well, I guess I'll have to take the old-fashioned way out. Yeah, using the door like a human being. How do I access my inventory? Right-click. Okay. Look. Growly. My grappling hook launcher made to look like an umbrella. That's why it's called a growly.
Okay.
It's just, like, making up words. I'm not sure why
I'm... Is he gonna run through the door with the umbrella?
Yeah.
Oh. I was kidding.
Okay, you wanna click on the... You wanna maybe try clicking on... Oh, jeez. I changed the resolution, so... Okay, well, I can do that. I can change the... I changed the resolution from 320 to whatever.
Hello.
Oh, no. No! Stay away from me! Stay away! Ah!
And go.
What got into him?
You're scary, dude.
Oh, wait.
No.
Take off my mask. I hate forgetting I'm wearing this thing.
Yeah, it's a little scary.
But who the hell was that guy? I was under the impression this house was empty.
It's a
intrigue.
Ghost.
I'm gonna open a door.
Oh, okay, why would the ghost run?
Locked.
Of course.
Well, there you go. Why can I touch this now? I think there's an Easter egg if you look at a door a million times. It's a door. It's a door. It's another door. It's what we in the trade call a door. It's a large rectangular piece of wood used to fill large ungainly holes in walls. It's a door. What more is there to say? As you've probably already figured out, this is a door.
My goodness.
My keen senses tell me that this is a door. Is this a door I see before me? It's larger than a window and smaller than a garage, so I guess it's a door.
That covers it.
I think of all the doors I've seen here, this is by far the best. I take it back. This is the best door that... Sir? I used to go out with a girl who had a door just like that.
That's a little...
Have I already told you about the girl who had a door just like that? Her name was Patricia. Oh, she had the most... Okay. Earrings I had ever seen.
Nice.
Anyway, she left me with the lacing of the doors. I just know this door reminds me of her, I suppose. Sorry, I have a tendency to ramble and players won't stop looking at the bloody doors.
There we go.
All right, there we go.
Can you go down... No, he didn't go down the stairs.
No. What is going on with my stomach? It's like I got hit when the. It's like yes. I got hit in the gut with a crowbar. Open the door. Locked.
Okay,
let's see. Did I try this door?
Yeah, that's the one you talked to for 10 minutes.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
All right, let's try this door.
That hourglass is a bit annoying.
Locked.
Okay. Open.
No, it's a bathroom.
Well, it's still open. Okay, that's the room. Okay, we've shifted perspective.
At the mirror on a very understated mirror. It's a sink. Well, I hate bidets. They're so decadent. An immaculate porcelain lavatory. It's just an ordinary bathroom mat.
Big mat.
Door! Okay. Window.
Tub?
It's impossible to see through them clearly. It's a shower curtain, or rather, a bath curtain. This bath is very clean and white, probably recently used. Oh, I hear whispers.
Well, that's not freaky at all.
No. Nope.
Somebody in the tub? Am I gonna jump?
Oh no! Nothing here. How anticlimactic.
Well then, where the heck?
Well, he probably died or something. He went
the guy that was right there?
What was the first thing you said?
It was a ghost. But I swear. Well,
he's not a ghost. It doesn't really make any sense where he went.
Why
do you not do the go down the stairs? Go down there the stairs, go. Trilby. There you go.
That's a hat, isn't it?
Is that not the tackiest fucking door ever?
Like, excuse what even, me?
It looks like it's got like blue microwave, yeah. Microwave packing peanuts.
Well, is it supposed to be?
Should always keep abreast of day-to-day events.
Yeah, how up to date is that? Okay.
Trilby.
What the heck? Oh.
Telephone. Line's dead. Somehow I was expecting that. Doors. No latch, no chain, no deadbolt.
So you can't open them.
I doesn't even have a keyhole. So I don't want the bloody thing open. It's gonna be very tiresome. Why don't you just break a window? I think it's like, yo, you can't break the windows because magic or whatever.
Oh.
I think finding a way out of this place is hiring my party isn't stealing the furniture right now. What about the what about the sofa? A nice sit down can wait for later. Let's look at the dresser. A Welsh dresser. How very bourgeois.
Man, this guy's snobby.
Some examples of popular Victorian fiction. It's a rather amateurish landscape. The signature identifies it as the work of Matthew Defoe, circa 1818.
Artist into family.
And
a rocking chair.
There we go.
If that thing starts rocking.
What, you're gonna get skeered?
No.
I'm gonna take this cord.
What?
Because who the hell is gonna use a VCR in this place? Television.
VCR,
and no comment at
really.
This time. Mm-hmm. In other news, the society world is still shaking by the sudden death of Sir Clarence Defoe. Sir Clarence and his wife Julia were found dead last Thursday in Defoe Manor. Mm. Our correspondent Peter Daltrey has the report. It was just 4 weeks ago that this place was a buzz of activity as Sir Clarence Defoe moved in with his new bride Julia Swanson Defoe. Now, after the shocking tragedy, the place is quiet as the tomb and empty of human life.
Yeah.
Sir Clarence had only proven his attachment to the Defoe lineage almost 1 year ago, and since then had been renovating the long abandoned family mansion in preparation for his marriage. The police have already declared their tragedy as murder-suicide, although many have insisted that their Clarence was incapable of such an act. The debate rages on while the fate of the house and family fortune remains unclear. This is Peter Daltrey, BBC News, Defoe Manor. Thank you, Peter. Our top stories again. Minister. I hate television. Well, that happened. Hey! It's about time you showed up. What? I'm sorry? Well, you should be. I've been stuck in this house for days.
What?
Where's the way out?
Who are you?
I'm sorry, I don't understand. You are the guy who owns this place, right? No. Oh. So how'd you get in here? A window on the second floor.
Let's just be honest now.
Is it still open? No, it jammed shut. Damn. Well, looks like the house has a new guest. I hope no more turn up. We've only got 5 chairs. If you'll excuse me, I've got work to do. Excuse me. That was him, not me.
Sure, okay.
Wait a minute. Yes? Who are you? Oh, I beg your pardon. Harty's the name. Philip Harty. Call me Phil. And you are? Trilby. Mr. Trilby, I'm afraid you are now a prisoner. Like me, like everyone else in the house. I would advance the text myself, but... that's why, wouldn't you get in the house, won't let you leave. Oh, no! I've tried all the doors and windows, but none of them open. If the text advances right before I click, then I end up skipping text. The garden wall's unclimbable and I can't tunnel under it. But why? Who's keeping us here?
Well, hey.
Beats the hell out of me. Whoever it is, they will certainly not be safe from my fists once I get out of here.
Sure.
So if there's something you're not telling me, now would be a good time to get it off your chest. I assure you, I'm completely mystified. So how many more people are in this place? If I could talk, that would be nice. Only three more. First, there's Jim, the youngest. He turned up just after I did. He's a good kid. Okay. Second, Simone Taylor.
Hmm.
You probably know her off the telly. She's a correspondent for the BBC.
Hmm.
She came here to make some kind of documentary, I think, but now she's stuck here with us. Lastly, there's AJ. Skinny bloke with a stash. He won't tell us where he is or who he came from. Wait, that didn't quite... Wait. All I know is that he's been here longer than anyone, nearly a whole week. The text on the background isn't very easy to read. I think I've already met him. Oh, what a heartwarming story. Well, excuse me, asshole. Anyway, why don't you see if you can track them all down? Well, why can't you do it? Yeah. I'm calling a house meeting in the lounge. Spread the word. Spread the word to people you've never met, and you don't know what they look like. I still don't understand. Just my nose is in the other lounge. Thanks, Phil. We can discuss things properly then.
Where's the lounge? Oh, that was at the couch. Okay.
Alright, well, that happened.
Well.
Let's look at some stuff in here. We got a tiger head. A stuffed tiger head, mounted in the act of snarling, presumably to justify its death in some small way. That's not enough to kill animals in Africa, he's going to do it in Canada, too. Evidently, someone fancied himself as a big game hunter, and they just fancied themselves. Oh, you're so snarky and witty. A very old sepia photograph of a man in explorer's gear standing over a dead tiger. The label reads, Sir Roderick Tames, a vicious beast. That gun he's holding looks a lot like the one over the fireplace. What a curious
coincidence.
Well, this thing have this thing.
Do you want me to read?
I'm not carrying this around everywhere. I better find a place to put it down. Well, fine. I'll put it on a trilby. I don't want to use that on myself. Yeah, I guess not. Hearth. What is that? Even if I wanted that ugly thing, which I don't, I'd have to break the glass to get to it. What is it? What actually is it?
Like a rose or something?
A glass bell jar containing a rather hideous-looking wooden idol. Look at that. You see that?
It's like flippy flipping in and out. Loud floors.
Yes, or Trilby takes very manly footsteps.
These.
Not very becoming of a gentleman thief, I'd think.
Yeah, it'd be kind of hard to get your thieving done if you're tromping around like that. So we're going to go up.
Yeah, Yahtzee explained that in the engine he made the game in, you couldn't differentiate... Oh, hello. You couldn't differentiate between vertical and horizontal speed, so...
Oh, okay.
Pardon me, madam.
What?
Hello? Oh, hello. Philip mentioned we had a new guest. When did he do that? Why didn't he tell you to meet him in the lounge when he did that? Yes, he must have seen me on TV.
Well, I don't watch TV.
And you are... Trilby. Got a first name?
Mister.
No. Hey, wait a second. You're not the cat burglar, Trilby. Oh, good. Oh, wow! I presented a Crime Watch special on you once.
Well, good.
Oh, man, I wish I had a camera right now. You're a correspondent for the BBC. You don't have a camera, like, on you anywhere?
Well, not if she's just...
I guess, well, you wouldn't consent to an interview, would you?
Maybe it's in the door.
Why am I... Even if I had a sudden retarding brain injury that would cause me to do so...
Why would
Don't you think our apparent imprisonment is a slightly more urgent matter?
Do they not have Wi-Fi?
This isn't like the 80s, I think. Well, I admit I thought so the first day I was here. What? We didn't have Wi-Fi in the
80s. Shut up. Okay.
I think I'm learning a lot about this place. So happy. If I could just get these infernal doors open, why don't you just kick them down? Philip's calling a house meeting in the lounge. Yes, it's so like him to do that when a new face appears. I'll see him later, Mr. Trilby. The text scrolling, the automatic text scrolling is just long enough that I have to pause awkwardly when I'm done reading.
Yeah, but...
But when it's a short...
Scream!
Strange woman. But when it's a short text box, it's, like, perfect.
Yeah.
Let's go downstairs.
Okay, the creaking's annoying.
Alright, let's go through the door. La-da-dee-da. Look at that portrait.
Dining room.
Look at this graph. It's a pleasantly professional quality portrait of a bearded man in a Victorian explorer's outfit. It looks like he's in a raincoat. Little plaque at the bottom reads Sir Roderick DeFoe. That looks like a straight up raincoat.
Because, I mean, well, I suppose sometimes you wear hunting orange, but sometimes you wear, like, not, so you don't get seen.
It's too big to carry around with me. Like, what were you hunting in, like, a land of cheddar cheese?
Well, no, but so other hunters don't shoot you.
Oh. Evidently, no one cares about starving this place.
Well, they weren't real expecting you, sir.
No, what's in here? Absolutely...
nothing.
Maybe I have something to cook, but I don't. All there is in this whole kitchen is a big bag of salt. But if I ever need lethal quantities of salt, I'll know where to look. Mm. Why is that the only thing in here?
For traps?
Why? Like,
oh, he got out!
They took all the food.
Oh.
But they didn't. But they left the salt.
Well, yeah.
Oh, a stick. Pick up sticks. Oh, derp. It's a tree! With a very perfectly vertical... Hey! Huh? With a very perfectly vertical trunk. Talk to the tree. Is someone up on the tree?
Trying to climb the tree. Climbed the tree.
Oh, hi. You're new. Have you come to set us free? No, apparently I'm a prisoner now, too. I am guessing you must be Jim. What were you doing in the tree?
Trying to get out?
I thought I might be able to get over the wall.
You...
But, the tree's too far. And there's this ravine just outside the wall, too. Probably should have mentioned that first. So I understand, yes. Philip wants us all to meet up in the lounge. Oh, okay. I'll head there now, then. Oh, there's not much you can really explore out here. There's like a pool.
Oh, okay.
There's a lawn with some big holes that Phillip's dug up. Cheerfully. Rolling around at the speed of sound. Where is the... Oh, the lounge. I always think that this is the lounge.
Yeah.
But no, the lounge is where that rocking chair was.
Okay. Yeah, it's the living room.
Yes, I suppose.
Or the
If you want to be Western about it. Ah, our new arrival is gracious with his presence.
Oh,
I think there's a lot you want to know. Join the club. So you're all trapped in this house by some invisible intelligence.
Ghost.
Oh. Right. And you can't leave.
That's what trapped means.
Nope. And as soon as I entered, I became trapped too. Pretty much. Why? Oh, they didn't want to keep us a prisoner here.
Evil.
Maybe they're just lonely. No, if they wanted company, they'd have shown themselves. Maybe they have.
Oh.
Maybe one of those is behind all this. Oh, don't be silly. Why would any of us want to trap a load of people here and pretend we didn't? I don't know, do I? I don't speak loony. We mustn't squabble amongst ourselves. I'm going to solve all the problems because I'm the main character. Hampered by paranoia and suspicion, we'd only hinder each other. Aw. I suggest we assume for now that we four are all innocent. I agree with that, so happy.
You're guilty.
We five, including AJ. Where is he, anyway?
Dead.
He died. I couldn't find him anywhere. I saw him just after I arrived, but he ran away from me.
Oh,
into a dead end, and then I couldn't find him. Well, that's odd. Listen, Mr. Trilby. We work as a team in this house, and that's how it's been since it started. So we all have to share information. I can't read today. So, why did you come to this house? He's a cat burglar. Do you even have to ask? Why do you even have to ask? Well, I didn't come here to take part in some bizarre Big Brother event, that's for sure. Is there anything you know about this house that would help? I don't think so. Anything at all? I don't know much more than any of you. All I know is that the last heir just died and it's supposed to be empty. Hmm. Well, I guess you're not much of a help then. But I suppose an extra pair of hands is always useful. I'm still not completely clear on a few details. Do I get to ask you all some questions now? Sure. Just ask any of us whatever you like. Talk! I can't move. Miss Taylor?
Yes?
Oh dear, that's gonna be slow.
Oh my.
Whoa, that was... Oh my gosh, I can't even move the...
What is it doing?
What the heck? Oh boy.
I take it didn't do this first time through.
Nope.
No.
No, come on. This appeared for like half a second. Can I, like... No! The cursor appeared. If I could have clicked it, I could have saved, and then we could have, like, started the recording over.
Uh-huh.
All right, let me just... Oh, I got it! Well, I've heard some pretty disturbing stories about it.
Oh, man.
Here we go. There have been stories of weird happenings around it for decades.
So that's why you were doing a documentary.
Ever since the first disappearance of the original owner and his son, people have gone missing in the area around the house from more than anywhere else in the country. People from all walks of life. People like us? Don't say that. No! Don't put me back in here. Okay, well, I can just bide my time. There you go. How did you come to be here?
How did you? Okay.
I only came down here for a documentary. There's been a lot of interest in old ghost stories lately. We figured something on Defoe Manor would pull in the ratings. And not because it would make interesting viewing. This is why I hate television. Thing. Excuse me, I was talking. I arrived here before the camera view. I was supposed to wait for them, but I couldn't resist taking a walk around the grounds. Next thing I knew, I was in the backyard. I looked all over, but I couldn't find my way back to the front. It was my own fault, really. Yes, it was. Nobody asked you, dickwad. let's just take a little bit of time. Yes! Tell me a bit about yourself. So sweet of you to ask.
Great. Okay.
We're in for it now. I'm a correspondent for the BBC, but you probably already knew that. I'm afraid I don't watch my television. Oh. Well, I do some breakfast for the news, mainly. I can't talk! Sometimes I present documentaries or variety shows. Whenever I'm needed, really. Very much a Jill of all trades. That's all I wanted to know. What happened to your camera crew? What happened to your camera crew? We might be able to keep going if I... I've no idea. They probably just left when I never showed up.
Hmm.
I'm sort of glad they didn't get mixed up in this, too.
Or they're dead.
Quite. That's all I wanted to know. Well, we could have used some food. Okay. Can I, like... Okay, let's save. The grocery's full? What? Okay, I'll just replace that one, I guess. Replace. Two... with, chunks. Okay, that'll do. Okay, now let's,
what are we gonna do?
We're gonna stop the recording. Mm-hmm. We're gonna reset the game into different resolutions, so maybe it actually freaking works. Oh, okay. And then, we're going to keep going.
Okay.
So, see you...
Bye.
...in a second, from your perspective. Ladies and gentlemen, we're back! The saving actually worked. We had to go through the whole game again to get back where we were because the save file didn't work because we were running in a different mode. But now we're running in this mode, so that's good. Let's talk to Asshole McGee over here. Mr. Hearty? Yes, Mr. Trilby. What do you know about this mansion? Plenty. I read an article in the Advanced Treasure Hunting Monthly. I was built by some explorer guy, Sir Roger Defoe, something like that. I don't even guess.
Good picture.
It was Roderick, by the way. His wife died giving birth. He and his son went missing some time later. That was him. That wasn't me. Hell, maybe the article could tell you better than I could. I burped again. Did you notice that?
Uh-huh.
I'll let you borrow it.
Please carry articles.
This is some quality voiceover work, let me tell you what. Just don't mess it up too much. It's for my scrapbook.
Well, yeah, you're never getting out of here, man.
Yeah, pretty much in a way. How did you come to be here? Well, I came up here to look for some artifacts with an E. That's how you know they're serious. And I'm sure you had this full consent of the Defoe solicitors to do so.
Oh, like you... Oh, no, that's
not... Shut up. Jeez, man. I just heard some of the old family tombs somewhere on... Heard of some old family tombs somewhere under the building. I mean, really old. Anything inside probably doesn't belong to anyone, so finders keepers. I managed to call in a few favors to get over the ravine in the back wall.
Why didn't he go in the front?
Of course, I couldn't get out again. How many people know you're here? A handful, I suppose. They wouldn't get suspicious till I go missing for months, though.
Wow, his mouth looks ridiculous.
Tell me a bit about yourself, even though I don't really care. About me? Well, I'm in what you call the import-export business. You're a thief. I am not a thief. I'm a treasure hunter.
You need a hat.
I only take what belongs to dead people. Well, you know, since they're not using it, you know. Our new friend there, he's a thief. True, but also a gentleman. And I only take what I'm sure no one's using, too. I'm sure that's a great comfort to them. That's all I wanted to know. Righto. Oh, Jib. So, Jib. Yes? That's all I wanted to know. What do you know about the mansion? What do you know about... What if Trilby just had a cold and they did that voice for him the whole time?
No, please.
Not much. We could always just go about see the roof over the playground wall. We all used to tell each other it was haunted.
You look kind of pale.
Why? Were there any stories or legends attached? Well, a friend of mine used to say a crazy hermit lived there. Who killed people and ate them alive. Oh, I'm certainly reassured.
If they kill them, then they're not eating them.
That's so stupid. You just hear like, oh, the aliens, they have to keep the humans alive because they feed on live humans. Uh-huh. How stupid is that? Well, what the heck does a human have that they couldn't get just by eating a pig?
Different taste?
That's not important for survival. They eat live humans. Just give them a pig we're happy now.
Well, you know the whole thing. I can't believe I'm getting into
this. If they're eating emotions or something, yes. Then they don't need to kill, then what's the big deal?
We have more complex emotions?
Yeah, but like, who cares then?
We're actually having this conversation about aliens.
Anyway, how did you come to be here? I was so stupid. It was so stupid. We climbed over the school wall at lunchtime.
Me?
Why? It was a dare. We were going to see how long it would take the school to find us. Then we came across this old house, and Richard dared me to knock on the door. He bet me a pound I wouldn't do it. My school was like that. Broke my collarbone playing pylon once.
Oh, dear.
Shut up, Philip. Jeez, man. What happened next? Well, I was about to knock on the door, but it opened by itself. I heard Richard dare me to take a step inside.
What?
So you did, and the door closed behind you, and it wouldn't open again. Yeah.
Everybody else ran away.
Your friends didn't call the police or anything. How should I know? I guess they didn't, since nobody came. That was on Wednesday. The school probably knows I'm gone, though. I see. Tell me a bit about yourself. Like what? I don't know. Where were you before you came here?
At school.
I was at St. Trinian's boarding school, not far from here. Been there since I was 10. My parents move around a lot, you see. How old are you now?
Kate.
Nearly. Sorry, I had coffee before I did this. That's all I wanted to know.
16?
Okay, anyone else here see the pattern in all these stories?
Yeah, y'all.
Which pattern would that
shouldn't
be?
Shouldn't be here?
Seems to me the house only trapped people individually. It didn't try to trap Jim's friends or Simone's camera crew. It's only letting us in one at a time. You're talking about the house like it's intelligent. Surely it's more likely there's just some joker behind all this. Oh, dang it. How did you know that we were coming? How did it know to leave a window open for me, risking one of you finding it? Well, I guess it's just a mystery. You think the house is haunted?
Oh, God.
I wouldn't use that word.
It's too early in the game.
But I definitely have a very odd feeling. Like we're being watched, I suppose. Yeah. Maybe this is one of Simone's rating winners. Excuse me? Well, locking up some people in a house against their will and secretly filming them? Sounds like a natural reality TV progression. It's also highly illegal. Wouldn't stop some people. Where the hell has AJ got to anyway? I mean, that's basically the premise of the Truman Show.
He's dead.
I was hoping he'd be here. He'd be doing some research on the house. He was going to share it with us tonight. Maybe someone should go look for him.
He's dead.
What, now? I admit I'm beginning to feel tired. Yeah, me too.
Oh, sure. Let's all sleep.
But what about AJ? I don't think there's any need to worry now. If he still hasn't turned up by morning, then we'll look for him. And he'll probably be dead anywhere. So who cares at that point, right?
Let's not waste our energy.
But we'll look for him as soon as we get up. The energy we don't have because none of us are eating. Day two!
That was a quick transition. I guess he slept on the couch.
What was that noise?
I hear noise.
Oh man, suddenly there's actually sound in the game. This is new.
Oh
my gosh!
Oh my gosh!
No!
Sorry.
Simone? Philip? Jim? Oh god, who did this?
AJ, hold!
What the? You did this?
Well, he's breathing heavily.
No, stay back. I'm warning you.
What are you going to do? Hit him with your mask?
Who are you?
Well, you mentioned a mask, didn't you? AJ. Whoa!
You see it?
I did. I did indeed.
Christ, I've never dreamt so vividly before. It was so disturbing.
I don't want to go out that door now.
That's fine. Who was just dreaming?
Yeah, I don't believe you.
Besides, I thought that was gonna go into the TV room, and I'd be like, besides, this is just the TV room. But no, that definitely just goes there.
Okay, now he's going to the kitchen. Everybody's dead.
Hi, Jib.
I'm eating a book.
Jib. Hi, Mr. Trilby. Do you know where the others are? I don't know where Hardy is, but Miss Taylor's up in the library. The library on the second floor.
Really?
I think she broke the door open or something. Thanks. See that? So that is a possibility.
But
you can just
cold?
Break. You can break the doors open.
Well, sure. Yeah.
What are you reading there? Treasure Island. I found it in the living room. How are you liking it? Well, it's a bit heavy going. I think I prefer Terry Pratchett. Seen AJ anywhere? Not since yesterday morning. He seemed pretty anxious about something. Did he say why? No. Just said something about getting to the bottom of all this. Then he left the room and I never saw him again. How are you feeling? Okay, I guess. I had this really horrible dream. But you don't want to hear about it. You're taking this imprisonment thing very well, I must say. Well, it's not that different from boarding school, really. Except there's no one to hit you across the knuckles when you talk too much at night. Okay, that's all. I don't know why I could ask him where the others were again. Wait, well, hold on.
He didn't...
Look at the picture.
What's on the face of the picture?
His beard is graying.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Ah, my eyes.
Ah. Is that a hand for a cursor?
Yeah, that's my like use cursor. If I need to use something, then I hit the use.
Okay.
With all these air quotes in your face.
All right, thank you. There's something floating in the pool. Nope.
No.
Bottom of the pool. Nope.
I can't get to it anyway. Oh, hello.
Oh, he's trying to dig his
way. Hey, Mr. Hardy. Well, look who's up. Have you seen the others? Why did I ask him that? I don't care. Okay, do you know if AJ's turned up yet? No, I'm just...
He fell in a hole.
Blah, blah, blah. He must have been in on it. Maybe he's out of valve.
Been in on it?
How all the hidden cameras are working. Honestly, this is work of the BBC, Philip. Do you have a better explanation? Not yet. Well, then.
You only have 7 actors.
What are you doing with the metal detector? That's actually part of the plan to get out of here. Oh, good. I've heard that there's some kind of family tomb buried somewhere under the grounds. If we can find it, there might be another way to the surface. And I presume any valuables in there would happen to be an unexpected bonus. Hey, judge not, lest ye be judged yourself. You're a cat burglar, for God's sake. At least I have a sense of priorities. Well, when you found an escape route and saved us all, I'll be sure to apologize profusely.
Wow.
Are you the one who dug up half the lawn? Yeah, I was trying to dig my way out of this place, but the ground gets really solid 2 feet down and the wall foundations go even further. Well, that would explain the holes nearest the walls. What about the others? Happy now? You want some kind of metal? Just professional interest, you understand. Any luck? With treasure? Found some kind of pipeline running under the lawn, but not much else.
You can ask him about how you knew the tomb was down there?
The tomb never comes into play.
Alright.
I don't want to get it under my fingers. I don't want to use the dirt. I want to walk to the left.
Well, maybe they find a candle and that's a gas pipeline that could just blow everything up.
Yeah, that would get us out of here.
Well, it would end it all. Yes, this is where you get your morbid streak. Okay, not you, but your siblings. Okay, Mark. Back to the dining room, and now... Okay, never mind.
It's not going to escalate that quickly outside your dreams. What? What?
Running up the stairs, it just sounds like...
Where am I going?
Well,
no, my face is all dry because I had that shower, dagnabbit. Oh, wait, isn't this the library?
No, she was at the one in the corner.
Oh, this one's all broke.
No, the one in the corner is
No, she broke the door. She's in the library.
I didn't know it was the library. Okay.
Hey, Miss Trailer. Miss Taylor. Ah, hello, Mr. Trilby. Sleep well? Did you break the lock on the door? Sleep well? To be honest, not really. I had this terrible dream. Someone was killed in a terrible gym. Or he's over with all the men. Let me guess. He took off the mask and it looked exactly like you. No. And he looked exactly like you. Oh, good. What does it mean? Frankly, I don't want to know.
Yikes.
Did you break the lock on the door? No, I just came up here and it was like that. I suppose AJ must have done it. He must have been reading from that pile of books. I don't know exactly, but I have to ask him. But I take it AJ hasn't turned up yet. No, do you think he found a way out? If he did, he didn't have the decency to tell us. I wouldn't be surprised. He's kind of jumpy. Maybe he just saw an opportunity and took it. Maybe.
I did.
What do you know about AJ? Not much. He refused to tell us anything about himself, where he came from, why he came here, not even his full name. Kind of suspicious, isn't it? Do you think he had some kind of agenda? I really wouldn't know. Of course you're going to judge when it comes to withholding names. Heh.
I was thinking.
How are you holding up? Oh, spare me the gallantry. I'm just fine. Well, excuse me, princess. See you later. Sure. Well, great. I'm going to look at... Every single different color of books is a different thing you can look at.
Oh.
Encyclopedia Britannica...
With double usedness.
Unabridged Oxford English Dictionary. These don't come cheap. Delia's How to Cook series. Interesting. A couple of binders containing old architectural plans for Defoe Manor. That sounds like it could definitely come in useful. I can't think of a use for any of these. What? No, move out of the way so I can collect the books. Dude! I want to get a map or something. I'm checking old road maps and atlas is probably tragically out of date. Lovingly bound textbooks on gardening. Books on the occult? No doubt interesting bedtime reading.
Sure.
The shelf is full of nothing but photo albums. That one at the very end, I think, is actually its own thing.
Except maybe it won't let you click on it.
Yeah. Click. Don't hiccup, man. You're crazy. Books on photography, cartooning, and watercoloring. Some of P.G. Wodehouse's best.
Who's that?
No idea.
I know that name.
Historical texts on most of the really well-known noble families. History of the Defoe lineage. That looks interesting. Can I read it? Ooh, yeah, whispering. Nope. I think it's about time I read up on the Defoe family.
Can you hear it?
Yeah, I can hear it.
So have you listened to the words?
No, it's just whispering.
Oh,
it's
I got words.
It's just like, you got words?
Yeah, I got words.
What'd you get?
Destroy.
That's weird.
Yeah.
Okay, I think it's about time I read on the Defoe family. I got the book now.
Put your phone away,
I'm looking up P.D. Wodehouse.
Seriously?
Yes.
You can't look that up after?
Well, it might come in handy.
Okay, you play this. All right, no.
It's not going to come in handy.
All right, okay. So which book?
A History on the Defoe Family. No, it's just indecipherable. It's just meant to be indecipherable whispering.
All right.
Roger Defoe, later Sir Roger Defoe, is probably the most famous of the lineage. This is a very professionally written textbook.
I agree. Using
a lot of the inheritance he attained when his parents died suddenly, he embarked on a series of adventures throughout the globe, earning quite a reputation as a colonial explorer. He retired from adventuring at the age of 40 when he met his future bride, Belinda Rothman, and fell instantly in love.
Aww.
He built a luxury manor in the English countryside, and the couple moved in as soon as the work was complete. By all accounts, the couple were deliriously happy, which is what made Belinda's sudden death while giving birth to their only son, Matthew, all the more tragic. Sir Roderick was in mourning for a long time, leaving the upbringing of Matthew in the hands of numerous nannies and tutors. When he finally did start taking an interest in his son, he was known to be bitterly disappointed as his son rejected the idea of joining the army, preferring to pursue art and literature. As Matthew neared the age of 18, however, he and his father seemed to grow close. His father seemed to grow closer. They didn't always see eye to eye, but they seemed to understand each other and offer unconditional love.
Yeah.
And then, on Matthew's 15th birthday, he and Roderick disappeared. Good. A servant found bloodstains in one of the rooms, but no bodies were found. The fate of Sir Roderick and his wayward son remains a mystery to this day. The first of many mysterious disappearances entered the Defoe family, run in the family house.
Well, then.
Well, good.
Too bad you can't look at those plans.
Yeah. Tim Rowland's one of called the Digest of Visual Arts. Why are you looking at me, Samode?
Go away.
Okay. Can I pick up this map yet? Map. Well, fine, if you don't want my money. What am I even doing?
How long ago did you play this?
Well, I just watched Yahtzee himself play it on his YouTube channel, less than a week ago. Okay. I haven't played it since, 2013, maybe.
Oh, okay.
And I've never played the latter two entries in the series.
What's
hey, that? Jim. Nothing.
His face looks like a pumpkin that's deteriorating.
Okay.
He's whispering again.
It is.
I'm mysterious and spooky.
I'm trying to... This, you know, for how big this place looks on the outside, there's not much to it.
Yeah.
Step. And step. Can you go in the garden house? Whatever the heck that is?
No, it's locked. Let's look at... Looks like a pipeline comes away from the pool and goes under the line. I wonder where it leads. The water is deep and smells strongly of chlorine. Perhaps if the pool... Wait. There is a blurry shape visible in the water, but I can't tell what it is. What could that possibly be? Perhaps if the pool were drained.
Perhaps it's AJ. Yo,
maybe.
Dude.
Hey, Phil, give me your damn metal detector, you piece of crap. Hey, Mr. Hardy. Well, look, ow.
Sorry.
You just hit my arm with your glasses,
Sorry.
Cheerfully.
Sorry.
How do you know the tomb's there? I don't. That's what the metal detector's for. What? Probably all these ones known as the corpses. Actually, you'd be surprised how much metal can be found in a tomb. Belt buckles, coffin handles, candlesticks, gold, silverware. Implying something? Oh, goodness me, no. Listen, the tomb could be on the other side of the grounds for all you know. Sure, but this is a good place as any for a start. And if all these things are compelling items for this location, I'll continue my systematic sweep. Oh.
Wouldn't it be easier just to excavate the whole thing rather than in holes?
Well, remember, he's got one shovel.
No, but I mean, starting from one and working your...
Okay, now that he said, I want concrete proof, or otherwise I'll keep my systematic sweep going, now I think we go get the map from those plans, because now we know that we need them.
Okay, so just the order of things. Okay.
Yeah, it's event flag. Very, very flaggy.
Okay.
Let's go in the busted door.
Ooh.
Look at these books. A map is always handy. Now, if you look at the map, it's a very old architectural plan of Defoe Manor. There's Defoe Manor with blah, 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 an underground tomb clearly marked as being under the front yard. Ha ha. There's something odd about this map. Like, there's something missing. You notice it?
Well, hold on. Okay.
Something I don't recall seeing in the house.
So this is the first floor and second floor?
Yes. And this is, like, tilted, like, 90
yeah,
degrees.
Yeah, I see that now. Okay, so yeah, there's the staircase. And that...
I don't want to hear footsteps.
This?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What room is that?
That's the kitchen, isn't
it? That's the kitchen.
Yeah.
Apparently there are stairs going down from the kitchen.
So let's go.
What could possibly go wrong? Every single time I come down those stairs, it goes into, like, cutscene mode for him, like, going down the last couple of steps, and I think something important is going to happen. But nothing ever does.
So is he gonna, like, take somebody with him? Of course not.
No. Wall.
So you gotta hit the wall.
I'm not gonna be able to do anything with my bare hands. Yeah,
don't worry, Chzo.
Alright, let's just walk all the way across here again. La da di da. It's weird how you click with the middle finger of the hand. Like, look, the edge of the cursor is the middle finger when I put it all the way against the side. Alright. Hey, Mr. Hardy, look who's up. Can I borrow your metal detector? What do you want it for? I'm not sure yet. Brilliant. Okay, well. Can I use map on Philip? Hey, Hardy. Mr. Hardy, I found this old map in the library. Did you? Take a look. The tomb is quite clearly under the front yard. But this is the backyard.
Duh.
There's no way into the front yard. Sucks, doesn't it? Well, I guess that's my escape plan out the window. Thanks a bunch, buddy. Don't mention it. Can I borrow the metal detector? Why the hell not? Take away my hopes so I don't take my only worldly possession, too. Have fun with it.
I think the
thanks. Now do excuse me.
Shovel might be... Okay.
Alright, so now we got a metal detector. We can actually use metal detector on one... I don't know where to begin. I need to start it. Look! Look at the lawn! Digging right out. No, it seems only looking for something. Can I look at the individual... Oh. Okay, I gotta come over here and use the metal detector on the pipe. Use metal detector on pipeline. I can track where this pipeline leads with a metal detector. And he does it automatically, thank goodness. The trail ends here. Use. Look. That's me. Yes, it sure enough is. Do I need to have it? Do I actually need to get a... ASDFGHJKL. I think I need to get... Oh, do I have to get a shovel?
Well... Where's... Okay.
Because I don't have anything I can use to dig it up.
Nuh-huh. That's why I thought... I was surprised you didn't have a shovel there, too. That you could say, I need a shovel.
Yeah, Let me walk all the way back into the mansion. If we don't find anything, I can just cut this out later cheerfully.
Okay. So you can't look in the pool yet?
No.
Oh, you have to drain it.
We have to drain it, which is why we're trying to figure out where the pipeline and all that.
I thought you were going to knock a hole through the wall.
I think there's a pickaxe somewhere around here. But I don't remember where. Probably not buried in the salt.
Under the table.
Let's look at the table. There's nothing on or under the table. Well, good. Excellent. Jim? Hi, Mr. Jolie. No, you're useless. Cool. Goodbye, Jim. Crack my hand.
Your phone?
Well, the line's dead.
Oh, right. Under
the... Notice something different about that painting?
No, I didn't. What's different?
There's a figure on the horizon.
Oh! So there is. That is not a tree.
No.
Don't like it when
things change.
Let's
look at the TV.
No, I don't want to look at the TV! Wait, I thought he took the...
No top story this morning. Police are still baffled by the apparent disappearance of television personality Simone Taylor. Simone Taylor was new for a film documentary in the notorious Defoe Manor, but her camera crew reported that she never arrived. Police are visiting the building, but so far have no way to get inside. The photo family solicitor, Michael Chesham, has the only key to the building and is currently unavailable. Miss Taylor's disappearance coinciding with the disappearance of a local youth from a nearby boarding school simply add to the legend surrounding the mysterious Defoe Manor. Reports. Okay. I forgot to pick up the cord when I came, when I had to get through the whole thing again. I forgot to pick up the cord that time. Mm-hmm. Okay, there's nothing in here.
What do you... Okay.
I don't remember what to do. I need to figure out a way... I mean, I couldn't even look at the holes. I could only... All I could look at was the lawn.
Is there...
Yes, yes. Creepy whispering.
Is there anything else you could maybe pick up this time?
What sun bleach skull. What, I don't want the nasty thing.
What about
thing.
The book right. at the end?
What do you mean?
The one that you couldn't... The that one.
I don't know. Hey, Miss Taylor. Hello, Mr. Tilby. Okay, never mind. Where did Philip go?
I don't know. He just walked into the house.
Okay, no. That's still part of the photo albums, I guess. I feel like that will become more important later, but... I don't remember exactly when.
Is there anything back in the room you came in?
I don't think so. Locked. Also locked. No, there's nothing in here. It's gotta be out in the lawn, I guess. I can't think of where else it would be. Yeah, there's nothing in here. It begins.
And you can't go through that front door.
No, no. That's that. That actually leaves the mansion.
Oh, okay. Well, that's very weird.
Yeah. Salt. Yeah, I don't. Can't do anything with that. Cross the tree makes the upper branch. Pushing the tree makes the upper branches very little. What fun. Can I look at the tree? Is there anything in the tree? Nope. Alright.
And that's locked.
Locked. Don't any windows open this stupid place? Can't you just punch it really hard? Water. I didn't bring my trunks. Good. I think I'd best leave it alone, but you need to drain the pool, Captain.
Isn't that the shovel?
I can look at the dirt. Phil's library must have covered it up. Panel. Well, that doesn't seem to do anything.
Turn around, but the pool's empty.
I can't believe it was there. Come on.
Maybe you just had to go.
Yep, pool's empty.
Walk.
Pool's empty. Use the ladder. What could possibly go wrong?
You can't just look there, okie doke.
Christ! Oh, Christ. Oh, no.
So walk closer.
Ooh. This is definitely the man I met on the landing. Presumably AJ. I'm turning the volume a little bit down because, oh my goodness, hello. But I think he was dead before then. His throat's been split open by some large-edged weapon. Ugh, the stench.
So let's stay here.
I've got to find the others. Yeah,
you're never getting out of the pool.
Dead? How? Murdered. He was stabbed to death and tied to the bottom of the pool. It looked like somebody slit his throat, not stabbed him.
Yeah.
Oh my god. You know what this means, don't you? We are the only ones in this... Oh, don't give me this crap. Not necessarily. I don't think any of us could engineer... Shut up! It was you, wasn't it? You killed AJ and now you're covering your tracks. Philip, you're being absurd. You want to help me tell us where the body is if he wanted to hide it.
He's covering his tracks. He was last to arrive, though. Tell me you're not a bit suspicious of him.
Look at the edge was terrible. But if we let it tear us apart, we could all go the same way.
He's got a point, Philip. Oh, I see. You're all in on this together. Oh, for crying out. Philip,
shut up. As far as I'm concerned, there's no one I can trust anymore. I'm going to make this as much of a problem as possible. From now on, it's every man for themselves. Okay, bye. You're walking into a dead end. Philip!
Idiot. He's shaken. We all are. So what do you think? About AJ, I mean.
I think I killed him in my sleep.
I'm really not sure. I think we're being haunted. Oh. Well, at least someone's keeping their head. Look, I'm not exactly in love with such an unscientific idea as a murderous ghost. But nothing other than the supernatural could have engineered this situation. And this house has a bad history.
a history I think it's time I started looking into. Well, do whatever you want. I'm going to go look into AJ's death with a slightly more sensible attitude. Where's Jim? Someone should tell him about AJ. I think he went upstairs. I'll go look for him.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Oh, Jim? No.
There's a jump scare warning coming. Hey, watch. What are you doing, Father? What?
I'm watching.
You're watching? Yes. No, don't. Father. Father. Hold on. Oh. When did he fall asleep? This is what I want to know. When did he fall asleep?
Has he ever woken up?
Day 3. Yes.
Oh.
Jim? Sorry, Mr. Tilby. You wanted me to wake you? Did I? Oh, you told me about AJ, then you said you were going to look into the house. Then you asked me to make you this morning so you could get started. Yes, I remember. Thank you, Jim. Anytime. Well, that happened.
Oh.
All right. What, the no figure's reflection? Gone.
It was there when he sat up.
Was it?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
This morning. In other news, Michael Cheatham, solicitor of the Defoe Estates, was found dead this morning in his office. Oh, good.
Oh, so it's outside the house, too?
Nah, probably not. It's too much of a hanged himself, and a ruling of suicide has already been declared. This is the latest in a recent string of deaths and disappearances connected to the mysterious Defoe Manor. Kind of a boy. A string which began with the murder-suicide of Sir Clarence Defoe and his young wife, and has seen more recently the disappearance of the family. Police were hoping to acquire the key to Defoe Manor in order to investigate the location of the key, which
was only not just received from himself.
The more television starts tomorrow, we come forward to picture of Mr. Sarah becomes increasingly apparent that I hate television. So they told me there wouldn't even be that much coverage if there wasn't a celebrity involved. Well, isn't that just a punch in the pants? Alrighty, so what do we do now?
Wait for 3 more days till everybody else is dead?
Well, I mean, time isn't going to pass unless we do stuff. Hello, AJ. How cooperative are you going to be today? Hello, Philip. Leave me alone, cat burglar.
That's really gray now.
What are you doing? None of your business. Are those maps of the house? Oh, yes, they're maps. I'm going to find a way out, then I'm going to get away from this mad out once and for all. After that, if I ever see your smug pinstripe wearing face soon, it'll be a million years too soon. Again. One of those. Come on, Phil, none of us could have possibly killed AJ. You want to bet? You're over 6 foot. You could have done it easily. Maybe I could have, but I didn't. Prove it. I can't prove it. Well then, you know, your attitude could be the death of us. It's certainly going to be the death of you if you don't get out of my face. Well, excuse you. Well, I'm just peaches. Now go away. Alright, let's look at this. Yep.
Yep.
His beard is significantly graying, and Trilby seems to not notice. Well, it's magic.
Well, but usually if things die, it's to make somebody younger, not make them older. Supernatural.
What? What's this? I just found that out here like this.
It dropped.
Do you know whose it is?
From above.
Yeah. It's mine.
Oh!
Did you bring it in here last night or something?
Yeah.
Of course not. It was in the front yard and there's no way into the front yard. Maybe someone's trying to help us.
We're going to drive through the house.
Maybe. I'll go and find the others and let them know about it. Alright, sure. Check out that animation on Jim walking around. It's definitely my car. How it got to be here is something I certainly can't explain. Let's use the car. Use the car. Oh, I can actually... Great! My lockpicks are here.
Ah!
They must have fallen out of my pocket while I was getting out of the car. What the hell kind of cat blurgler are you? I'll hide an emergency pick in the lining of my tie, like I usually do. Alright, there you go.
You got, like, a gun in there?
No, we got lock picks.
I know, but you got some food? Chocolate bars?
I love Flask. Chocolate bars.
Who's that from?
That's from Punch Out.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Mac Baby, I'm gonna tell you a secret. I love chocolate bars.
Oh, now I want a chocolate bar.
I'm going to open this door. This bright cyan fashion disaster door. Like, who the hell?
Yeah,
a bright cyan door. Cyan? I don't... It's not turquoise. And it's not just light blue. Not light blue. Nah.
Well, why don't you try picking the... There's no lock on the front door.
Never. No.
Right.
No.
That's what? Where you came okay. in.
I have no freak... I guess I should go look for Sabode. Oh, hello, Jib.
He's whispering Jib? In the black books.
Yes. What do you think we should do next? I think we should be doing as much research into the house as we can. Have you seen Philip and Simone? Philip and Harrison Diamond Hall. Mr. Lark said she was investigating AJ.
She's in the pool.
She's in the pool. I should have. Going to the pool when I was doing, man. Should have gone to the pool while I was in the backyard, man. No. I'm just going to have to walk all the way back there cheerfully. Yeah, go ahead and make more noise in the microphone.
Look.
Sure, go ahead. I think that's probably a good idea. Crunch.
Happy?
I can't think of a use for these at the moment. Okay, fine. Uh-huh. Welcome. You can think of a use. Seriously? Are you serious with these crackers right now? Are you source? I'm just gonna look at all the damn things. Maybe these books? I can't think of any use for these. That's what I just clicked on, Captain Einstein.
Oh.
Evidently, someone's been doing a little research here. Okay. The Digest of Visual Arts. That's novels, text, books.
Yeah, because you're speaking better without crackers than I am with them.
Ow. Ooh. World road maps, Delia's How to Cook series, photo albums. I already found the ones that were like, actually, okay, I don't think there's any information in the library, as stupid as that sounds. I'm gonna go talk to Simone Taylor, maybe that'll set off some event flag that allows me to actually read a book.
You also have two doors to pick.
Yes, but two of them are still locked. The other one's the bathroom. We didn't know what happened last time we went into the bathroom.
Yeah, I know, but you have lockpicks. That's the whole point.
Oh, yeah!
Okay, shh.
No, I actually forgot.
I'm like, dude.
I was so busy worrying about freaking libraries and Simone's in a pool.
Well, I'm sure she'll be dead soon.
Maybe.
Now there's two bloody bodies in the
pool. Now she's dead. No, she's here. Hello, Sabode. Oh, Trilby, how's the ghost hunt going? Someone brought my car into the backyard. Yes, I noticed. It's your car, is it? Did you bring it in here? Trilby, I have no idea where it came from or how. I'm just glad to see a little bit more color about the place. I see.
She's wearing the same color as the door.
What are you doing? I'm investigating, like we all should be doing. So, what do you concluded? I found his wallet. He had ID for almost every government agency I can think of. Everything from MI6 to CID. Really? I think he must have been sent to investigate the house. Some kind of secret mission. That's why he never told us anything about himself. It would make sense, certainly. And I say this because it's a pretty spectacular failure of that mission. Any clues on who did this? Yeah, he must have been a pretty big fellow, I think. Armed with a large slashing weapon, like a machete. Oh, and had a piece of leather. Leather? Like Philip's jacket? No, it wasn't leather black. Armor. Brown leather. Like leather armor.
That's what you were wearing.
There was a torn off piece in AJ's whatever he said. She said, okay, bye.
So, is he going to remember, that's
what
I was wearing
in
my dream?
Well, I mean, he probably realizes, but he's not going to bring that up.
Hey, I dreamt.
Did anybody else dream that I killed everybody?
You can also pick
How brush. Weird is that? No, you don't need to go in there.
How weird is that? You all had the same dream.
That's one of my favorite moments in this game, actually, is when you ask AJ, it's like, let me guess, he took the mask off and it looked exactly like you. And it's like, no, it looked exactly like you, actually, Trilby. It's like, oh. Grand.
That's your hand. I keep thinking when you pause with the cursor. Yeah, it's like, it was in the window. First scene, I'm like, what the heck is at the window?
Okay, I don't need to come in here. Oh, and now that I have the lockpicks, I can open, the doors. And then when I open the doors, I can use the lockpicks to open the doors.
Ladies and gentlemen.
No, did it work? I think I did it, but it still won't open. There must be a deadbolt on the side or something. How about this one?
Don't you have a deadbolt?
No. You gonna do it? There we go. Unlocked. Hooray!
Hooray!
Hooray! You were totally ineffectual. Look at this red-ass room.
That's, yeah.
A bed.
Oh, boy.
I'm not sure I would feel right living in a dead man's bed. Can I get out of the way? No, I don't think so. Book! Will you quit yelling, man? You're crazy. Let's look at this. Oh, it's a diary.
Oh, boy.
Diary of Sir Roderick Defoe. March 5th, 1805. Work on the house is going well. It should be completed by the end of July. Belinda is already excited about the forthcoming wedding and spends many hours of the day going over even the smallest details over and over again. Not since our early courtship has she been so giddy with joy.
Oh,
it softens my heart to see her smile, and she smiles often. I am wondering why I didn't retire sooner.
Because you were working.
August 12th.
1805. I am only now having the opportunity to write this, as it had been the most hectic day. The wedding went without a hitch, and the house was ready for us to move in as soon as the ceremony was over. Belinda insisted on consummating our marriage immediately. I am sure, dear diary, this house can expect to bear the laughter of children before 1806 is out. February 14th, 1806. A romantic day for our announcement. The physician has just left, confirming that Belinda is with child, a child we can expect to be born in June. We have already decided to name the child Matthew if a boy, or Jane if a girl. July, June 28th, 1806. Belinda is dead. I will never forget her face, ash grey, contorted with pain. The child is healthy. Would that it had never come about and spared me this fresh hell. May 24th, 1820. Matthew showed me the painting of the grounds he had created. I worry about the boy. Why can't he have healthier interests, like soldiering?
Good.
The painting was fair, I suppose, but I would rather my child be less of a weakling.
Oh, dude!
June 28th, 1821. It is the anniversary of the night I unleashed a horror which I tonight shall remove from this world. May God forgive me. That should be July 28th. That was retconned a bit later. That should be July 28th. That's important.
Oh, okay, because otherwise, that's the last entry. It's kind of, yeah, okay.
July 28th becomes an important date later, but I think Yahtzee forgot that it was June in this game.
Oh, so, okay, because that changes the whole meaning of the date, right? Like, yeah okay.
June 28th has no meaning, but July 28th is an important date in this mythos. Scratches. It's not blood, it's just scratches. I can't think of what to do with it. Well, look at it, Captain Einstein. Jeez, man. They don't look like you're made by human fingernails.
Oh, it's an alien. It's an alien.
I can open the window. Well, what do you know? It opens.
Jump!
Of course, since it overlooks the backyard, this doesn't help me much.
Oh.
Let's go through the open window.
Climb on the roof.
Aww. Okay, what? Well, there's a... Okay, well, this is the tree.
It's
busted. A tile that must have come away slightly during the rebuilding. It's a very old, very dead oak.
Hmm.
The window must lead into the room up at the end of the other locker room on this floor. Guess what I got?
You got the grappling hook.
I got the grolly, but...
But you can't use it?
Well, I'm sure it would be highly amusing to grolly up the gap and slam heavily into the tree trunk. It would not be a great help. Yeah, so we got to get rid of that tree first.
Oh.
I'm not entirely sure how we're going to do that. There's a...
Somebody's walking.
Oh, maybe we do have to go into the shed. I think we do have to go into the shed, because there's a... I think there's a saw in the shed.
Oh, okay.
That we can use to cut down to the tree.
Okay.
And then we can grapple into the other... what I presume to be a bedroom.
Oh my goodness, it's 3:30.
Yes, it is. Use lockpicks.
This reminds me of lockpicking and... Morrowind, or whatever it was.
Skyrim. There we go. Alright, let's go into the shed.
What's dead in here?
Nothing dead in here. There's a pickaxe, though.
Ah!
And there's a big-ass saw that Trilby's just
going to
carry around with him.
In the hat of holding.
Alright, so we can try to use the saw on the tree.
That's a two-person saw.
Yeah, but this is not a one-man job, so we gotta go get somebody's help, and the best person to get...
Simone!
No.
The jerk.
Like he's gonna help us.
Oh.
We gotta get a little kid to help us cut down a tree. What could possibly go wrong? La-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Let's go to the library. Use saw on AJ.
No.
That doesn't work. Okay, good. I was kind of wondering. It's like, what? How do I ask him to do this? Okay, do I have to talk to somebody else about this first? I should have been able to ask him to help me with that.
You have to get turned down flat by...
Yeah, Philip? Probably. Hey, Philip, want to help me cut down a tree? Use saw on Philip. I may need it. That's why. Did I just talk to the door? Oops.
If the door answers...
Alright, let's go talk to Sabode. Waste more of our freaking time.
Jump in.
I'm not gonna possibly go wrong.
Drop the saw.
How much investigating do y'all need to do down here?
Simone, how's the ghost hunt going?
Oh, for the love of...
How do I ask him if that I want to use the saw? Maybe I have to look at the saw. It's a well-polished old two-man saw. Yes, that's true. But how do I get somebody to... How do I ask somebody that I... Talk. Saw.
No.
Look. Saw. Use. Saw. Well, that just lets that happen. I can't... I can pick... Okay, well, I already tried to use the saw on the tree, and it said it was a two-person mm-hmm. job, so I should have triggered the flag that allows me to ask AJ for help with it. This is not a one-man job. Therefore, I now go to AJ.
No, you don't. He's dead.
Right. Jim, I mean. Yeah. Jim. Jib.
And it is Jim. You think
it is Jim.
Yeah, that helps you. Okay.
It seems like a bit of a wasted thing of time that you have to ask everybody before you can ask the person that...
Well, I'm not sure if I actually have to. Jim. What do you think I should do? This is just wasting a chance. There's stuff on the house. Why? I don't know. Yes, you do, Jim. Why? Because I want to help. I'm not sure what I could do. Do you want to take along... Excuse me. Do you want to take along with me? Sure! I promise not to get in the way!
Well, that's important, because if you get in the way of the saw... You know, it looks like he's wearing either leather pants or... Dude, where are you? There, okay, came through the door.
Lagging behind me a little bit. Let's walk across the room. La da di da. We're about halfway through now. The whole game.
Oh my, okay. Yeah, you said it would be about 2 hours.
Yeah. Okay. So now.
Well, there is a sibling home.
Yes, they sure enough are.
They sure enough.
Where are you going, dude? Use saw on tree. Jim, give me a hand with this. Where are you going, Captain Einstein? Alright, great. What? Oh man, check out this stellar animation.
And it crushes.
No, we're both fine.
Okay. The shed. My car!
My car! Crap! No! Why did we cut the tree down, Mr. Trilby? I'm not exactly sure. I know it makes me feel better.
Oh, good.
You know exactly why you did it, Captain.
Yeah,
he'll call him Captain. He'll say Captain Einstein again in like over 1 minute.
He's being sneaky.
Oh, Jib, you don't need to follow me around anymore.
Yeah, so how do you get Jim to like stay put? You have to put him back in the library?
Just put him back in the library. Just pick him up and drop him in the library.
In the library.
Let's go into... Oh, okay. I'll just talk to him. How about we just talk to him? Talk to him. No, talk to him. Jim? Yes? Never mind. Okay. I think he just leaves automatically once you go out the window.
This is hilarious.
That really looks like blood. What are you doing, Mr. Trilby? Just popping out for some fresh air. Why don't you wait for me in the library? Oh, okay. All right. Now, we can use...
Did you want to save?
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Let's replace 214 with,
Chunks Ahoy?
Yeah.
Wait, that's probably trademarked.
Chunks to Electric Boogaloo. Boogaloo. Use Grawly on loose tile. Choo! Whee!
Looks like a gun.
Now he can go in this window.
And what'll he find?
This is Matthew Defoe's room.
Oh, this is depressing.
What is in here? A coat hanger. Fantastic.
We can only open one side of the wardrobe?
Easel. I don't paint.
Oh.
Good. That's what I wanted. It's an artist's easel with a blank canvas. How philosophical. A very old Victorian era stuffed bear. A rather understated nightstand. Let's pick up the bear. This is actually important.
Okay.
And why the hell not? Nightstand! Nothing in here but this old diary. That's not important. Look at the... Is that the...
No, that's the
other. This one.
Yes.
The Secret Diary of Matthew Defoe. Today is my 8th birthday. Nanny said I would soon be a big, strong man like my father. I wanted to see him today, but he wouldn't come out of his study all day. Nanny says he always gets cross on this day, but it's not because of me. August 15th, 1817. I found a new friend. He is behind the door in the kitchen and doesn't have a name.
He likes me to sit and talk to him, but Father gets very angry when he finds me doing this.
Oh, good! Oh, good.
I asked Father who the boy behind the door was, but he told me there was no boy behind the door, and it was just a silly fantasy.
Oh, good!
May 24th, 1820. I showed Father the painting I just finished. He said it was quite good, which is the best thing he's ever said. Well, while he was in a good mood, I asked if I could go and look behind the door in the kitchen. He pretended not to hear me. July 28th, 1821. My father has done a terrible thing. All this time he pretended there was no boy behind the door, and now this. There is blood all over the kitchen floor. I will do what I can, then we can be a family together and be happy. That's where it ends, except for a little ink blot just underneath the text. Good. However, keep in mind we have a pickaxe now.
Good.
We can actually go down. We can go down. What could possibly go wrong?
No. Keep. What's this?
Absolutely. What?
What's this call again? Five Nights at Freddy's? No.
5 Days a Stranger.
Okie dokie.
Use pickaxe on wall.
Here we go.
What could possibly go wrong? Oh. Knock knock.
Punch.
No. Oh. Go in the hole.
Oh, good.
Chains. Oh, suspenseful music is starting. Let me just explode the whole screen with this. What the hell was this room used for? You just read the diary, Captain Stoop. You should be able to figure that out. They're quite firmly attached to the wall. Alright, I guess there's nothing else we can do in here. Crack, crack.
Yikes.
Well, the music has gotten a little more intense, though. Aww. I'm gonna take a sip of my coffee.
Are you supposed to be telling people and stuff?
That coffee is really weak. Hey, Jim. Never mind. I think we have to use the occult books now.
Oh gosh.
I can't think of any use for it.
The salt would come in handy.
Don't talk to the books, me. Based on the occult book, no interesting bedtime reading. Okay, I think maybe I was supposed to look at the ground.
In the basement?
Maybe. Or maybe I should go talk to somebody else.
Some more?
Maybe, I don't know. I'm not sure what to do. Did I watch TV today? I think so.
Is it this third day?
Yes, this is still day three. See, the thing is, I know everything that happens in the game, but I'm not entirely 100% clear on what order it happens in.
Okay.
How's the ghost hunt going? Never mind. Can I show you the diary? Use diary on Simone. I may need it. Well, I need to figure out... Right now, I need to figure out a way... Well, let me just go back to the room under the kitchen, because I barely did anything. I barely did anything down there. Open the wall.
Take the salt.
Can I look at anything in here? Can I use anything in here? Have I read this?
No, you didn't.
Oh. But it was the curse that runs the cracking house. The daughter fell in love with his only son on the 15th year of anniversary of his wife's sudden death. After that, the house fell into a position of a succession of heirs, most of whom died or disappeared in mysterious circumstances. I can't read. The house was left abandoned after their last heir was thought to have died in 1946 until the recent appearance of Clarence Defoe, who managed to prove his connection to the lineage and inherit the house. Move, please. I already looked at these, I think. They're quite firmly attached to the wall.
Well, that's interesting.
Is there anything else I can... That's the family history. I read that.
Yeah, we got Clarence and we got Matthew. We got two names.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And Roderick.
Well, but... Yeah, okay, but...
I don't think Clarence ever comes up again. Oh, I'm gonna sneeze. Hello, Philip. Hello, Kenny.
Have you...
Okay, let me look at the things he's got on the table, maybe. I don't see anything important. Oh. Alright, fine.
TV? I thought you did watch TV today, but maybe not.
Maybe not.
I thought you did, but...
I could have sworn the next thing you had to do was... find a reason to read the occult books. Yeah, it was a popular Victorian fiction. Yep, uh-huh. Television, well, let's, if it's not there, that'll just be static. Yeah, we've already watched TV mm-hmm. today. Okay. Nothing in here.
You don't need the idol?
No. Okay. So it doesn't, it's like worthless anyway, okay. You know, whatever. It's just, yeah. Upstairs.
I'll see you at dinner soon.
Go flying. Okay, seriously. Can't think of a use. 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 Wait a second. Isn't there...
Oh.
I think there might be, one book that's actually different.
Uh-huh. Other than the one at the end of the photo albums. At the end of the top shelf, it's darker.
Yeah, that's just that's just the shading. That's weird that last one would be the same thing.
Yeah, it is. That's a funny way to describe it.
Yeah, research the house. Yeah, I know, but I...
Can you use anything instead of looking? Use the occult books?
That's what I'm trying to do. Oh, I can't... Okay. He Trilby does not yet think that we need to use them, and we have to... Right now, I'm trying to figure out what I need to do to convince him that they could be useful. Ugh. I can't help but feel like there's something that I can do in the basement.
Okay, well. We're gonna have practice for something.
Apparently.
So there's still nothing has shown up, there's nothing else in your car you could use? No.
Scanning for... just chains. Look, the chains. You gotta walk all the way over to see them. Are these medicals? Oh. What the hell is this room used for? Here, I have an idea. Let's stop the recording for a second and check a walkthrough. Alright, so, that'll be the end of the first episode, I think.
Oh my goodness, okay.
But, whatever. So yeah, I'm gonna go check a walkthrough. And we're back to 5 Days of Stranger. There's a newspaper here that I didn't see before. La da di da. Should always keep abreast of day-to-day events. Who is delivering this newspaper?
Well, it was... Maybe it was there before.
Yeah, I don't know. Just read the newspaper. This copy of the local paper dated last Friday. Heir to Defoe Estates found dead. Sir Clarence Defoe, last of the long-running Defoe line, was found dead yesterday in his home. Defoe, 24, was found hanging from a tree in the front house of Defoe Manor. His recent bride, Julia Swanson Defoe, was also found dead in the mansion, apparently stabbed to death. Inspector Jacob Barnes, the officer in charge of the investigation, has closed the case. There's no mystery here, he said. Defoe killed his wife and then himself. We have already disproved the possibility of a third party. Sir Clarence, the solicitor, Michael Cheeson, was in the last I know of Sir Clarence. He was infinitely content. He would never have committed such an act, plus there was no suicide note. I think I've read enough to have some idea what's going on here. If there is a ghost in this place, there must be some connection to the disappearance of Sir Roderick and Matthew Defoe. Well, was Matthew schizophrenic or something? Did Sir Roger kill him and it disappeared to avoid the law? It's odd that neither of their bodies were ever found. If I could find Matthew Defoe's body, perhaps I can get to the bottom of this. Maybe there's a book or something in the library that could help me. There we go.
There we go.
Now we can go to the library and read the occult books.
There's a lot of books.
Well, we find, one that we need, I guess. Kirby's very good at skimming. Why not? I could certainly do with a laugh.
Nice.
Book. It's a book on white magic. Finding a person from their possession. Tie the possession in question to a stick and dip it in the salt. Next, wave it over the place where the subject sleeps. When you hold it in front of you, the object will now indicate in which direction the owner lies. All right. What?
Thinking about the teddy bear.
Well, yeah.
Your mother.
Don't. Good Sorry. Grief. Okay, so we got some. So now we got to do some inventory puzzles. Footsteps. Including use cord on teddy bear. A little macabre, perhaps, but never mind. Use cord and bear on the stick. There we go. Now we go to his room.
You have to dip it in salt first.
I have to go up into the kitchen and then walk all the way back.
Where's the salt?
All right. Use bear and stick on salt. This is my life. Now I have salty bear and stick.
Guys, who shouldn't? I'm gonna walk through here. I have nothing to see.
What if he was just holding it in front of him the whole time?
Guys, like, and Hardy's like,
what?
Dude,
did I open the? Yeah, yes, I opened the door. Yes, you did. Mm-hmm. Now use salty bear and stick on bed.
Oh dear.
Nothing scary happening. I guess that'll do. Now we can look at the salty bear and stick, and it says, it seems to be indicating downwards.
Jump!
So I'm going to cut right to the chase and go to where it is, because I know where it is.
Go to the down.
Yes, that would be the case, wouldn't it?
Well, yeah, I mean, there's not a lot of choice here. No. You're just, you know. No. Yeah.
Nah. Ah. Bah, bah.
Give me a warning before I, like, you know.
Yes.
That's really, see, that cursor just looks...
I'm scared. All right. There's no jump scare here. Don't worry about it. I probably shouldn't tell you that. That kind of ruins the suspense. It's indicating to the northeast. Now we start getting more specific things. So we're going to use it and look at it again. It's indicating to the southeast. A little bit to the side. Look at it again, cheerfully. It's indicating to the east. A little bit to the east. Look at the bear. The bear indicating to the south. Look at it again. It's pointing straight down.
Pickaxe.
We don't need the pickaxe.
Oh, hello!
Matthew Defoe, I presume.
Why, yeah.
Did Sir Roderick keep him down here? No, he can't have done. There would have been mention of it in one of the books I read. So, hold on, I don't think that's Matthew's hand. There's another corpse down here. Looks like the body of a much older man. You know, I have a feeling this is Sir Roderick. Judging by the ribs, he was killed by a large stabbing weapon. But by whom?
Oh, jeez!
What was that? Sounded like he came from the other side of the house. Calm down, it's gonna be okay.
Sure, okay, come on, I'm good.
It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
I'm good.
It's gonna be okay.
It's not nighttime. Is he sleeping again?
My mom is leaning all the way back behind me and holding onto the back of my chair. Like a wuss.
Stop it!
Ow.
My mom hit me. Okay, so who's... Wait a minute. Other side of the house. Oh, the dude's back the
dude's
in the painting.
Dude's back in the painting.
Okay, she's outside, he's upstairs, he's in the dining room. Oh!
The glass thing fell off and the idol's on the ground.
And the animals are bleeding.
No, they just got like... This really is a horrendously ugly little wooden idol. Hang on, what are these little stains?
Oh, I wasn't imagining things.
Day four.
So, oh, jeez! Here we go again. Oh, but this time he's not dead. Sorry!
I wonder if that volume actually shows up on the recording, because I probably just ruined that scene.
I'm sorry.
Oh, gosh, my head. What? What the hell happened last night?
He's in the shed.
I remember. Oh, no, Philip. Did I kill Philip? I don't remember anything. Last thing I remember is putting my hand on...
the idol.
That idol! I've got to warn the others.
They're all dead.
No, I want to go inside. Look at window. It's stuck shut. Trilby. Look at Trilby. That's me, Trilby. Thanks, Trilby. I'm not wearing my tie. Talk at window. Hello? Is there anyone out there? Quiet. Simone? Is that you? Yes, I'm keeping guard. Why? Shut up! You killed Philip! Don't even try to deny it. I did? Don't play games with me. I'm keeping guard here until the police get into the grounds. Then I'm handing you over. Well, that sucks, basically. Simone, what do you want now? What makes you think I killed Philip, anyway? Oh, well, let me see. First, Jim and I are attacked by some huge guy with a welding mask and an apron with a machete, but managed to get away. Then we come into the kitchen and find a huge guy in a welding mask and apron unconscious next to Phil's corpse. And then we took the mask off, lo and behold, it's you. Well, you got it all wrong. Oh, really? Well, then let's hear your version. I was possessed by the ghost! Oh, now that impresses me. Did you think of all that by yourself? It's the truth, I swear! Shut up. Just shut up. It possessed me just like it did when I killed AJ. What are you talking about now? The ghost! It talks to me late at night when no one else can hear. Trying to make me do things, evil things. Shut up. It never leaves me alone. I can't sleep. Then I have the blackouts. I'll wake up with blood all over me in an unfamiliar place. It's happened so many times now, I can't count them. Shut up! Kill AJ, kill Philip, kill everyone. It wouldn't leave me alone. I'm warning you! I'm delirious with guilt most of the time. I can see the face of every poor innocent I've killed every time I close my eyes. Most evenings I cry so hard I vomit several times. Most of the time I just want this nightmare to end. If death came right now, I'd welcome it. Ugh. Simone, let me have my tie. Your tie? Please! Oh, to hell with it. Have it, you psycho. Got our tie back.
Did he hang himself?
I'll just slip it on. And here's my emergency lockpick. See, this demonstrates the importance of forethought. Oh, you sly son of a gun. She took everything except the bear and the book on white magic. Use lockpick on door. There we go, unlocked. Excellent.
So he was just...
Where's Simone got to now? I've got to get her and him to believe me about the idol. Alrighty. Ugh. Oh, jeez. There he is.
He is dead.
Yep, he is very dead. It's Philip. Someone is running through with a machete. The worst part of it is that someone was probably me. Are you intrigued?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Oh, goodness.
Oh! He's got a scary
ghost face. The portrait of a skeleton in a blood-stained safari suit. The black reads Sir Roderick Defoe. Looks like the Scream.
Mm-hmm.
That's a skeleton. It's a very tall-mouthed skeleton.
Like his mask.
His mask was just a black garbage bag.
Well,
same. I'm just saying. So, I have no idea where everybody went. I'm going to say before I go into the bathroom. People are chunking around upstairs, too.
Crumbo what?
Crumagob.
Okay.
Le crumb. Le crumb bath. Rum.
Wow.
There we go.
French immersion at its finest.
All right. Let's go into the bathroom.
Do I need to hide?
No. No one in here either. Wait, what? Where the hell is everyone?
No!
Trilby! I know you didn't really kill Philip or AJ. You do?
I did.
I figured you were lying to get me away from the shed. But I saw him again. Who? The killer! The guy in the welding mask! I spotted him downstairs, but he didn't see me. Well, thank goodness. And I can't find Jim anywhere. Come on, you have to listen to me. The ghost. Oh, shut up about your ghost. This isn't a ghost, it's a regular flesh and blood psycho.
Oh, hello!
Speak of the devil. Do something!
I'm gonna look?
It's just an ordinary bathroom mat.
Hiya! Oh.
Jim? Day 5. How is he? He's awake, he's fine. Doesn't remember anything, just like I didn't. Look, I only sort of half believe this possession thing right now. But in the absence of a better suggestion, I guess I'm going along with it. Have you been going over those books I was carrying? Yeah, and some text on the occult. Apparently if we want to destroy this thing, we have to get the spirit back to its old body. That'll make it quasi-mortal. It'd still be dangerous, but not unkillable. We'd have to find the body first, and to do that we have to know who the ghost is. I've been thinking about this, and I have a fairly workable theory. Yeah, I have a couple ideas about it myself.
Right, well, the ghost is something that happens to do with it, that has to do with the disappearances of Radrick and That's right, Simone. You really nailed it on that. Agreed. So, what do you think? What do you think?
Oh, jeez. I think, well, for sure, more than one son.
I think Sir Roderick had more than one son. Yes! Because of what I read in Sir Roderick's diary. Exactly! He makes references to some monster he helped create, and he doesn't mean Matthew. And Matthew talked about another boy in the house, a boy behind the kitchen door. Those manacles indicate that someone was kept imprisoned in the basement. Where do you think this other son came from? I want to hear what you think first.
Oh, okay, hold on. Oh. Well, I'm a little torn, because twins would make sense.
Well, why did he go crazy?
Or it could be the affair.
Why did he go crazy?
Who, Roderick?
Yeah.
Because he said he fathered a monster.
Yeah, but what? Why did he think it was a monster?
Because it wasn't her.
Because his wife died giving birth to it.
Right, yes, okay, so that's what I'm saying.
So if it was Matthew that his wife gave birth to and died, he would think Matthew was the monster.
Which is why I thought there were...
So she gave birth to twins, and the second one caused her to die in childbirth. Why she died,
yeah, okay.
Like Melinda Defoe gave birth to twins. I agree with that. I found Belinda's death certificate. She died about 20 minutes after Matthew was already out. I think it was the second son that did her in. Started to went practically insane with grief. Blamed the poor kid for her death, kept him locked in the basement, refused to even acknowledge his existence. Can you imagine what must have happened? What that must have been like for the boy, growing up in a filthy grotto like some kind of animal, given no education and no love. The boy would be completely retarded and insane. What?
Well, but...
He probably couldn't tell the difference between one person and another. If he was in one room alone for 15 years...
But his brother talked to him.
That's why he kills absolutely everyone who enters the house. Well, he probably didn't understand him. Mm. He thinks they're all Sir Roderick. Come to torment him some more. But what happened on that day 15 years later when Sir Roderick and Matthew disappeared? He found their corpses in the basement, so they obviously were murdered. Question is how and why?
I think it's three, but...
There is no third party here.
I was just thinking about the diary, where Matthew said, my father's done something.
Yes, so yeah. So his father has done something.
Yeah, I know, okay.
Men try to kill him. Yes! Remember, can I talk? Seriously! He talks about destroying the monster. He must have been gotten really drunk, and it being the anniversary of Belinda's death didn't help. He went down to the kid's basement and beat the poor kid to death. Half to death. Matthew found the body afterwards and tried to bandage him up. Matthew wasn't the sharpest tool in the box. His brother lived on for a bit longer, long enough to get the mask and machete and to kill both his father and Matthew. Then he must have just died of his wounds. Jesus. And we're going to try and destroy his ghost? None of anything that happened to him is his own fault. What little mind he had is no more. All he has now is hate. He's making a lot of assumptions here.
Yes.
If we don't kill him, he'll kill us all. I suppose you're right. It's very sad, really. What will you do now? I'm going to find his body. Then I'm going to figure out how to bring his soul back to it and destroy him. Well, let me know if I can be of any help. I will. Good luck. Thanks.
Bye.
All right, so first, we should go back in here and talk to, what's his nose? Hey, Jib. Mr. Trilby. Yes, Jib. Can I ask you a favor? Sure. I still have the mask and the apron and the knife from last night. Could you take them and throw them away for me? I really don't like having them around. Sure. Which is just what we needed. Thank you. No, thank you. Jim? Yeah, what happened last night exactly? Me and Miss Teller were in the living room. Then this big man entered in a knife and tried to kill us with a knife. We were able to get away, but then we heard Mr. Hardy screaming. Miss Taylor told me to wait here. A bit later, she came back and told me that it was you in the mask. I didn't really believe that. She went off to keep guard or something. Then I went into the trophy room and found this wooden doll thing on the floor. Next thing I remember, I was in the bathroom and my head really hurt. Did I really try to kill you? No, but something did through you. I don't like this place anymore, Mr. Trilby. You and me both. How are you feeling? My head still hurts a bit and I feel a bit woozy. Apart from that, I'm fine. Well, good. See you later. Excuse me. That's making noise in the microphone.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, well, now I've got the mask and the machete and the apron. You can't even read it because the menu's covering that up. I thought it was supposed to be a pair of scissors somewhere around here.
Oh,
the painting's straight up gone now.
little bit.
Not a good time to choke on coffee when you're recording and lose your voice.
So what do you need to do now?
Scissors, you said, right?
I need scissors because I need to do the same thing I did before, but to find the second kid's body now. But so I need to figure out a way to make another dowsing rod. Mm. And I have all the materials I need. Can I use the machete on the apron? Nope. Right. Why aren't you clicking on it? Okay. I have a stick, the machete. Mm-hmm. I have a belonging of his, the mask. Oh, they're right there. Convenient scissors. So now I can use scissors on apron. I've cut a thin strip off the apron. Mm-hmm. I can use strip on mask. I can use mask and strip on machete. And then I have the mask and machete. And then I can dip that in the salt.
And then downstairs.
Wave it over the manacles.
You need to dip in salt.
Oh, right. And I don't need to go upstairs for any reason at all right now. I'm just cheerfully wandering around. Yeah, use mask and machete on salt. Crack my entire hand apart. Go down here. Can I just... No, I actually have to use the hole. I can't just... Oh, right, I forgot you guys were here. Use this on mana, on chains. I guess it's like where I slept if he was chained to these all the time. Now I can look at these. They seem to be indicating upwards. I'm going to cut straight to the chase and go where his body is.
Upstairs.
Yes, very upstairs.
Oh, there's an attic we haven't been to?
No. Just more upstairs than I am right now.
Oh.
Not upstairs from downstairs, but
right,
upstairs.
Yeah.
Crack, my entire body's gone. In the bathroom, actually.
Mm.
Apparently he wandered all the way up here before he died. It's indicating to the northeast. It's pointing straight down. I can't get them with my bare hands. Well, fine. Right. Now you use the scissors on that to get the machete back, and you can use the machete on the tiles. I can lever up the floor with the machete. Pay dirt. I think this maybe must have been more deformed. Let's look at him. Body. The final resting place of Roderick Defoe's murderous younger son. After killing his father and brother, he must have been able to stagger all the way up here before dying from his wounds. And we pick up the whole body. Lovely. Look, remains. The heavily decayed remains of Sir Roderick Defoe's unwanted son.
How did he get in the floor?
The renovations. I think the real question is, why didn't the renovators notice his dead body?
That's what I'm saying. Somebody tiled him over.
Okay, so now we gotta go to the library. Because we have to find another occult book to figure out how to actually bring him back.
Okay.
Into that body. Okay. I'm just thinking about summoning angry spirits. I'm sorry, I couldn't read that with a straight face. The arts of black magic and necromancy.
I'll do it.
Summoning angry spirits to their bodies. Murderous wraiths are nigh indestructible when they can hop from body to body, but tying them down to their old bodies returns them to partial mortality, a state in which they can be destroyed.
Okay.
Simply enough.
Sure.
Place the spirit's original body in a place of fire and death.
return it its old clothes, then read aloud the following passage, omitting nothing.
Oh, good grief.
There's just a load of magic gobbledygook here. When I want to read it out, I should use the book on myself. Hmm. Warning, the summoning of a wraith will often bring forth other unquiet spirits who will haunt those who hold their possessions.
So drop everything.
Not quite.
Okay.
This is like the last puzzle here. We need to get the help of everybody else. Do you remember where everybody else was?
Yeah, he was in the bedroom.
He's in the bedroom, okay.
And she's sitting on the couch.
Yep. Jim, yes. Oh, okay. So I need to go... Place a fire of death. Fire and death, where do you think that's gonna be?
Fireplace?
Yeah, because there's all the animal heads on the wall, too. Right.
So stoke the fire. You have to ask her first.
Maybe. I think I need to put the body down first. Oh, never mind. Okay.
Why'd you ask her?
Oh, I should watch TV. I forgot to watch TV on day 4, didn't I? Budget. We can now go to Peter Daltrey reporting from the gates of Defoe Manor. Over the last couple of hours, a large number of police cars have gathered around the mansion grounds. I'm not exactly sure what the official position is. I have heard references to a hiker hearing suspicious noises coming from the mansion over the last couple of nights. What's happening there now, Peter? Well, since I arrived here and there have been 3 attempts to break the door down, all unsuccessful. I understand the authorities are still waiting to hear word from Michael Cheesham's office about getting hold of the key. Defoe Manor is, of course, reported to be the last known location of missing newsreader Simone Taylor. I actually read an entire line without stumbling over my words. Can you believe that?
Mm-hmm.
I hate television. Alright, so, do not touch the idol, apparently. Mm-hmm. Use remains on floor. I guess this would count as a room of fire and death.
Nice.
Nope. We have officially entered endgame.
So you better go get your pals.
Yeah. You can tell it's endgame because there's climactic music. No, not don't look. Talk. Simone, could you meet me in the trophy room? Do you have a plan? Yes, I've got a plan. Okay, then.
Is she going to be okay in there by herself?
Yes, she'll be fine. Okay. He's not going to enter the thing without me reading the incantation, so... I can't believe I'm saying this.
Bedroom.
Right. I knew that. Crack, my entire foot's gone. Talk. Jim. Could you go down to the trophy room? Why? I have a plan. Well, okay then. Let's boot it up, shall we?
Who's gonna jump out the window?
What? Oh.
Goodbye.
Sorry.
Dude.
What?
No, oh. The dude.
Oh, the dude's there. Mm-hmm. I see. Now, I'm going to give you the teddy bear. What is this for a gem? Whatever you say. And I'm going to order this gun.
Mm-hmm.
It's a literal Chekhov's gun. I'm going to give it to Simone. You wanted this for me, Simone? Is this part of the plan? Or do you just like to... Come on. Please, Simone. Oh, all right. Now, I need to dress it in its clothes.
Where'd you get the clothes?
From Jim. He gave them to
me. Right.
Oh, I put them all on at the same time. Now, finally, use the black magic book on myself. Here goes nothing. In this hall of death, and by the light of Prometheus' gift, I call thee. I bring thee gifts that may tempt thee back. I bring thee thy helm, that thy would be masked. Wow. I bring thee thy armor, that thy would be clothed. I bring thee thy sword, that thy would be armed. Come. Come. Come.
Looks like he's doing like a dance.
Now remember, they're holding their possessions.
Yeah, I know.
Jesus Christ, what now? Trilby, what? You... You! I knew you were evil from the moment you came into this world, demon child.
Ah, that's Robert.
May God forgive me for having a part in your creation. Why did you kill me, brother? I helped you when you were injured. I bandaged you when our father made his mistake.
Hmm.
No mistake, young one. Now do you see why I tried to keep you away from this creature? It has no understanding of human ways. You're wrong, father. If you'd have even given them a chance to be normal. Cease your prattling, Matthew. It's time to put an end to the horror I unleashed. What are you doing, Father? Father, no! Recognize this dialogue?
Yep, Father! Yep.
And he's dead. And he lights on fire. I think now would be a good time to take our leave. And there you go.
Hmm.
Miss Taylor, over here! What the hell's been going on in there? We've been trying to get in there for hours. Then the place suddenly catches fire, the doors burst open, and you two...
Two?
Us two? Where's Trilby? I thought he was right behind us. You're saying there was someone else in there? Trilby! Trilby! Wait a second. Trilby the cat burglar? Yes! Get someone in there, he could be in trouble! Maybe the ghost got him. Ghost? I think we better get you two down to the station. But Trilby... The fire brigade will find him if he's there. In the meantime, if you'd like to step this way... There you go.
That's it?
Death, of course, comes to us all. It came to Sir Roderick Defoe and his youngest son in the shape of each other. Was destroying the ghost the right thing to do? It was acting like any other dumb animal. Oh, well. I guess he and his family will have plenty of time to discuss it, wherever they are. As for me, I've lived a life many worlds consider out of the ordinary, and I have only one regret. Leaving Simone and Jim to explain it all to the police. That was hardly gentlemanly conduct for a gentleman thief. But I'm sure they'd understand that rushing out into a field full of police officers wouldn't have been a good idea. It's going to be a long walk home, and I have some important matters to attend to. I have to track down my fence, for one thing. Then I have to punch him very hard in the face. And that's it.
Alright, well, good. That was good, that was good.
What do you think?
Yeah, it was good. It was,
The end. That's the end of that sentence. It was, Yeah.
No, it was effective, and it was, you know, not too gory, and...
It stopped recording.
Oh. Just now?
Yep.
Okay, well, we ended. Did we run out of time? Like, did we...
No, it just... The game closed itself.
Oh, okay. So it's still recording us, but not
It's still
game.
Recording us and my desktop.
Hello? Oh, look. Look at all the icons on the screen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Look at all the emulators.
I even want to black those out or something.
Okay,
so what's next?
Next up after that is 7 Days of Skeptic.
Oh, I see.
Which is in space.
Theme. Space. Okay.
Yes.
Cool. Maybe tomorrow, maybe Wednesday?
Sure.
Yes. That's good.
All right.
Bye.
Any ending, closing comments? Because you never really finished your sentence before the game cut us off.
I know. Well, no, it was good. I liked Trilby. The characters were good. Honestly, I didn't know if anybody else was going to get out.
Mm.
Alive. I figured when she had the gun, I thought she was going to end up shooting Jim. You know, like right through the ghost and end, and then be like, oh no. Or that Trilby would get stuck in there, not dead, but like ghostified or something.
Yeah.
It was confusing what the dad did with the kids at first. Like, I thought.
Oh, yeah. Well, it is a mystery.
Yeah, because.
Any questions?
About this?
Yeah, about the story.
Well, it doesn't explain about the current murder-suicide, right?
Probably the same thing that happened to them that almost happened to us. The wraith of the unwanted child.
Right, yeah, like, okay.
Probably Clarence touched the same wooden idol, became possessed by the unwanted child, killed his wife, woke up, realized his wife was dead, and killed himself.
And killed himself, yeah. It's interesting, like, you don't get into the idol, the reason, or whatever.
Well, that'll come up later.
Oh, okay. Because, I mean, big game hunting and all this stuff, so obviously he got it from somewhere.
Yeah.
So, okay, yeah. You should just leave those things. You should bring those home.
Probably.
Yeah. Just say no. It's like, don't pick flowers from the wild. Don't pick idols from the... No.
No. Well...
So there's three more of these?
There's three more.
Okay. All right,
I guess that's it for 5 Days of Stranger.
Thanks for letting me watch.
Yeah, next time, probably like a week from this upload, whenever this goes up, will be 7 Days of Skeptic.
All right. Cool.
See you in 6 months.
Or less.
Nah.